Rahman said, we resume our class, inshallah ta'ala, of a tafsir. And we started with Al-Fatiha, alhamdulillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Help us and give us the ability to finish it now. Inshallah, we are in the beginning of Surah Al-Baqarah. So we finished the 20 ayah, but we said we're going to stay with it until we satisfied that we passed the 20 ayah with enough knowledge, inshallah ta'ala. Go, Ya Abdurrahman, اقرا
من اول شيء
من اول
اعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الف لام ميم ذلك الكتاب لا ريب فيه هدى للمتقين الذين يؤمنون بالغيب ويقيمون الصلاة ومما رزقناهم ينفقون والذين يؤمنون بما أنزل إليك وما أنزل من قبلك وبالآخرة هم يوقنون أولئك على هدى من ربهم وأولئك هم المفلحون إن الذين كفروا سواء عليهم أأنذرتهم أم لم تنذرهم لا يؤمنون ختم الله على قلوبهم وعلى سمعهم وعلى أبصارهم غشاوة ولهم عذاب عظيم ومن الناس من يقول آمنا بالله وباليوم الآخر وما هم بمؤمنين يخادعون الله والذين آمنوا وما يخدعون إلا أنفسهم وما يشعرون في قلوبهم مرض فزادهم الله مرضا ولهم عذاب أليم بما كانوا يكذبون وإذا قيل لهم لا تفسدوا في الأرض قالوا إنما نحن مصلحون ألا إنهم هم المفسدون ولكن لا يشعرون وإذا قيل لهم آمنوا كما آمن الناس قالوا أنؤمن كما آمن السفهاء ألا إنهم هم السفهاء ولكن لا يعلمون وإذا لقوا الذين آمنوا قالوا آمنا وإذا خلوا إلى شياطينهم قالوا إنا معكم إنما نحن مستهزئون الله يستهزئ بهم ويمدهم في طغيانهم يعمهون أولئك الذين اشتروا الضلالة بالهدى فما ربحت تجارتهم وما كانوا مهتدين مثلهم كمثل الذي استوقد نارا فلما أضاءت ما حوله ذهب الله بنورهم وتركهم في ظلمات لا يبصرون صم بكم فهم لا يرجعون أو كصيب من السماء فيه ظلمات ورعد وبرق يجعلون أصابعهم في آذانهم من الصواعق حذر الموت والله محيط بالكافرين يكاد البرق يخطف أبصارهم كلما أضاء لهم مشوا فيه وإذا أظلم عليهم قاموا ولو شاء الله لذهب بسمعهم وأبصارهم إن الله على كل شيء قدير
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim.
We quickly go on the rough meaning of them, then inshallah we highlight some points of each category we have of the people.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Alif Lam Mim. This is the book, in it is guidance sure, without doubt, to those who fear Allah, who believe in the unseen, are steadfast in prayer, and spend out of what we have provided for them, and who believe in the revelation sent to thee, and sent before thy time, and in their hearts have the assurance of the hereafter. They are on true guidance from their Lord, and it is those who will prosper. As for those who reject faith, it is the same to them whether thou warn them or do not warn them, they will not believe. Allah have set a seal on their hearts and on their hearing, and on their eyes is a veil. Great is the chastisement they incur. Of the people there are some who say, we believe in Allah and the last day, but they do not really believe. Fain would they deceive Allah and those who believe, but they only deceive themselves and realize it not. In their hearts is a disease, and Allah has increased their disease. And grievous is the chastisement they incur because they lied to themselves. When it is said to them, make not mischief on the earth, they say, we are the ones that put things right. Of a surety they are the ones who make mischief, but they realize it not. When it is said to them, believe as the others believe, they say, shall we believe as the fools believe? Nay, but of a surety they are the fools, but they do not know. When they meet those who believe, they say, we believe. But when they are alone with their evil ones, they say, we are really with you, we were only jesting. Allah will throw back their mockery on them and give them rope in their trespasses, so they will wander like blind ones to and fro. These are they who bartered guidance for error, but their traffic is profitless, and they lost their true direction. Their similitude is that of a man who kindled a fire. When it lighted all around him, Allah took away their light and left them in utter darkness, so they could not see. Deaf, dumb, and blind, they will not return to the path. Or another similitude is that of a rain-laden cloud. From the sky in it are zones of darkness and thunder and lightning. They press their fingers in their ears to keep out the stunning thunder clap while they are in the terror of death. But Allah is ever round the rejectors of faith. The lightning all but snatches away their sight. Every time light helps them, they walk therein. And when the darkness grows on them, they stand still. And if Allah willed, He could take away their faculty of hearing and sight, for Allah have power over all things.
Jazakallahu khairan. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Ahmaduhu hamdan kathiran tayyiban mubarakan fih. Wa usalli wa usallim ala khayri khalqihi wa alihi wa sahbih. ومن سار على نهجه واقتفى أثره إلى يوم الدين. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. اللهم آمين. My dear brothers and sisters, the last week we mainly highlight the talk about Al-Quran, the book, which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, the book. And this is the only book you say about it, the book, the only real book. The only book has all the information and the knowledge which the human can live in a proper way if they follow it. And if they follow it, they will be from the prosperous people, the success people, the righteous people. The second group, we are going to talk quickly about them. And you see Al-Quran in the beginning of this surah, when he talk about the three groups in the society, and every society has these three groups, the believers and the disbelievers, and the disbelievers in the makeup of the believers, in the clothes of the believers, in the look, the appearance from outside of the believers. This is what we call al-munafiqun. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala now talk about in two verses only about al-kafirin. First, we want to know who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about. Whom al-kafirin? Because if we look at the society, we know that the society in general, they were kafirin. Except a few in Quraysh, three or four, they followed the methodology of al-tawheed of Millat Ibrahim. So the Prophet ﷺ, when he came, everyone was a kafir, except these few. And Waraq ibn Nawfal was one of them, who gave the glad tidings to the Prophet ﷺ and said to him, you are the prophet of this ummah and the messenger of this ummah, and when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala command you to warn the people, and I am alive, I will support you in everything I have. But Waraqa radiyallahu ta'ala anhu died before that. So when Allah talk about these kafirin, if you warn them or you don't warn them, they will stay in the same state. They will stay kafirin. So who are they? Only Allah the Almighty knows who are they. Because those are forever, they will never receive the message. They will never accept the message. They will never submit to the message. They live as a kafir and they die as a kafir. When we see someone die as a kafir, like Abu Jahl, Abu Lahab, Al-Mughira, Al-Walid ibn Al-Mughira and others, we know these are from the ayat which mentioned here. These are the people whom Allah sealed their hearts. And if the heart is sealed, the light will never go through. That's it. Either he become a hypocrite or he stay as a clear Kafir. Who we can say this ayat talk about? None of the living one. We don't know who become a Muslim and who will not become a Muslim. Until that person dies, then we say this is one of the people whom the ayat described to us, whom these verses talked about. I don't want anyone to come and say, here, the Quran saying it's equally if you invite them to Islam or not. No, the Quran say about people, and these people are here in this world, but no one can say this one is one of them or this one is not one of them until their book is closed and their curtain is fall down and they pass away without announcing a shahada. You understand that part is the most important part, because some people, they go astray by misunderstanding that part. And they think if you are a Muslim or a believer, that's it. Like it is something you inherit and stays with you. It doesn't matter what you do. And if that person is a kafir, that's it. He's a kafir. Something he inherit, like you inherit your skin or your shape or your look, and you can change it. That's not true. As we know, when the Prophet ﷺ became the messenger of Allah, he was the only Muslim. Then Khadija and Waraqa believed in him. Then after that, we see Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anh believed in him. Ali believed in him. Uthman believed in him. And so many of the people we know, they were, all of them, they were kafirs. True? Of course. So whom we are talking about? Who, the one Allah the Almighty put them in that category in Al-Lawh Al-Mahfuz. If they are not written in Al-Lawh Al-Mahfuz as a kafir, then they are not from this people. This is in a simple form. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala only talk in two ayat. You understand ayat, yani verses, but we have to learn the, what they call it, the phrases in its original language. Instead of saying verse, say ayah. And verses equal to ayat. He only described them in two ayat because they don't need a lot of description. They are clearly there standing before you. But who needs a lot of work on them? They are the one who try to trick the Muslim and saying we are a Muslim, but they are not Muslims. Those are, and may Allah protect us if being in any way of hypocrisy, those are the most dangerous enemy of you. And for their fortune, Al-Islam block us from doing anything to them until they bring it out. Before that, we cannot really do much with them. And this is why hardly Islam treated them differently than the believers. Hardly. Only the people who show their real skin, like Ubay ibn Salul, Al-Ghassani, these two, they were yani, clearly showing their enmity to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his messenger. And in the same time, if they being caught, they used to make so many excuses and seek forgiveness of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi used to say, leave them, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will deal with them. But don't be stupid. We leave them, yes, but we shouldn't in any way not realize them and warn ourselves from them. The problem today, as the Muslims unfortunately become so much ignorant of that, they do not know how to differentiate between that we cannot treat them as a kafir. And this is where the trick comes. So they are our brothers and they are our sisters and we cannot talk about them? No. That's not true. And this is why we need to have that energy to follow the news of the people and not forget it and build our files of them. So you know a story, you saw something, somebody else saw something, somebody else saw, and if every one of us say, well, he's my brother, I'm not going to tell the sheikh or tell our brothers or tell the society about them, then no, every one of them will escape the society and destroy the society. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala first talk about what's in their hearts. First, they think they are the best in knowing al-Iman. They don't want anyone to tell them anything. You come to say, oh my brother, what you said is shirk, haram. Come and learn the true faith. You say, ah, we sit with these stupid people. Who's that sheikh going to teach us? Who's this? Who's that? Belittling others and highlighting themselves. We are the people who knows. We are the people who has the knowledge. We are the people who this and the real understanding, the good understanding, the understanding of life, the understanding of politics. And Allah the Almighty say about them, they are not true believers. But they feel not. And when he talk about knowledge, they don't know. They know not. Why? They don't feel they are mushriks because they try, as they say in English, to be in the safe side. In the safe side. What is the safe side? When you are with the believers, mashallah, you talk about Iman, you talk about truth about the mujahideen, about the jihad, about as soon as you go to the other group, you talk in the same language they talk about the believers. These people, backwards people, they don't understand the world, they don't understand the situation, they don't understand. Even they go worse than that, and they start to putting lies to make themselves closer to the kafirin. And if you ask them why, you say, well, I am in the safe side. No matter who win the game, I am his supporter. If the believers win it, then I am the first supporter of them. And if the kafirin win it, again, they know how much I played my roles to support them. I was their brothers, their supporters, wishing for them the best. And that, what Allah the Almighty call it, they try to deceive the believers and Allah. And Allah the Almighty put his name here to show you that playing with the believers and mocking with the believers, you are in reality standing against Allah. The believers, this is the people of Allah. They are not anyone. So you play against them, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will stand against you. Try to make mockeries. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make the best mockeries against you. And the mockery Allah made it against them, that he give them what they want in this life. They live among us as a Muslim and they die as a kafir, and they were in the day of judgment in the worst place in the hellfire. As the Almighty said, إِنَّ الْمُنَافِقِينَ فِي الدَّرْكِ الْأَسْفَلِ مِنَ النَّارِ. في الدرك الأسفل. So in the hellfire, tomorrow you're going to see, inshallah, Abu Jahl, Abu Lahab, in one place of the hellfire, and you see Ubay ibn Khalaf, Ubay ibn Salul, because there's one Ubay ibn Khalaf in Quraysh, Ubay ibn Salul. You see it in less areas, in worse areas than Abu Jahl and Abu Lahab. Even though, remember that, he used to pray behind the Prophet himself, salawatullahi wasalamu alayhi. He used to give charity, and he has to. Every time the Prophet ﷺ wants to give the khutbah, Ubay ibn Salul used to stand, as he is one of the top leaders of his community. Oh my people, listen to the Prophet ﷺ and obey him and follow him, and that's the best way to do. Then he said, and the Prophet start, of course this is showing off, and the Prophet ﷺ after that say, thank you, may Allah reward you for what you say, doing and saying. Then he starts his khutbah. So look what they used to do, and they still in the worst place, the lowest place than Abu Jahl and Abu Lahab. والله أعلم. So here, first, they talking about their hearts and their manners and their way of interact with others. You know, the Quran told us that even they went and built their own mosque. Why they build the mosque? So if anyone say to them, why we don't see you in the prayer? Alhamdulillah, I pray in that mosque. You don't come to Jummah, alhamdulillah, we have our own mosque. And when they built it, the Prophet ﷺ was about to leave to Tabuk. So they say, oh Prophet of Allah, come and bless that mosque for us. And the Prophet ﷺ said, inshallah, after I return. In the way, returning to Al-Madinah, the revelation came and told him, this is not a mosque. This is a place of hypocrisy, a place of diseases. You should go and destroy it before you enter Al-Madinah. So subhanAllah, he chose some of his companions and he said, go and burn that mosque. That place, sorry, you can't call it mosque. They call it mosque, Al-Munafiqeen, they call it mosque. The Prophet ﷺ entered Al-Madinah and that mosque was already on the ground, finished. And this ayat, talking to you about these people, to open your eyes, to open your heart, to make you understand who's really your brother and who's not, who's really supporting Islam in its real form and who's not. Who's trying to take you and pull your legs to traps in the name of Islam, in the name of Jihad, in the name of whatever they want. Every time we prepared a generation of good Muslims, and we say, inshallah, this will be the first pillar to build a good ummah, to build our nation properly. A hectic person come and made a story. And my beautiful boys and girls, they run to these traps. And they finish, if not all of them, many of them. And who's not killed or wounded and become disabled mentally. Because so much pumping and Allahu Akbar and Allah with us, and then he is defeated and he think, where is Allah? You always say to me, Allah with me, Allah with me, then I lost the battle. How come? They don't know. They are like the cattle being prepared to go to the slaughter yard. And this munafiqeen job is hypocrite. They take them one by one, 100 by 100, 1,000 by 1,000, and finish them. Then we have to start again. And it's not easy to build a generation. As I said, the rest who didn't either killed or wounded badly, they become themselves an obstacle in front of the da'wah. Because they come back with completely destroyed mentally, spiritually. They are very, very, very down. If you talk about al-jihad in front of them, they jump, they start to vomit. They don't want even to hear that word. If you talk about da'wah, they don't want even to sit with anyone. You see, so many of them, their hearts were killed by these, I don't know what to call them. And I saw some of that myself in my this short life. Wallahi, I see young kids, they become communists. You go to his house after Al-Quran and Al-Sunnah and talking about Sayyid and Hassan al-Banna and radiyallahu anhuma and this, you see big poster of Guevara or Lenin or Stalin or whatever. What is this, my brother? You say, these better than our leaders. These people, at least they succeed and they build the country. Subhanallah, a Muslim like you respect animals like these. But you see how the slab of their on their faces, what it did to them. Because they are still very green. They don't know much, except they have an energy to do something right. They take them to do something very wrong under the name of Allah and His Messenger, salawatullahi salam alayhi. And before that, if you talk to them, they think, who are you anyhow to talk to me? I am a mujahid and you are sitting at home. What do you know? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us and guide us all. Now, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala again from His mercy, He talk about how many category are al-munafiqeen. Al-munafiqeen, they are not all one type. So there is Ibn Salul type and there is other types. Two types mentioned in these three ayat here. مَثَلُهُمْ كَمَثَلِ الَّذِي اسْتَوْقَدَ نَارًا فَلَمَّا أَضَاءَتْ مَا حَوْلَهُ ذَهَبَ اللَّهُ بِنُورِهِمْ وَتَرَكَهُمْ فِي ظُلُمَاتٍ. الله أكبر. ظلمات. Many, many darkness. Not one darkness. ظلمات is a plural of darkness. What these darkness? Darkness of understanding. Darkness of belief, darkness of scenarios, darkness of doing the things in upside down thing way. And there's other people, still they are munafiqeen, but they are like kasayibin min as-samaa. فيه ظلمات ورعد وبرق. إذا أضاء الله لهم انتعشوا وقاموا. If the road is clear and nice, and that talk about the people among the believers, so they are not in leadership, but they are among the believers. The first category, they are in the leadership and they are taking people to the hill in this life before the Akhirah. They are among the believers. When they see the believers get stronger, get better, run the real course of Al-Islam, they benefit of Al-Islam, the light of their heart become good. So these people are not deniers. The first category, they are the deniers. Complete kafir. Has so much hate for Al-Islam in his heart. Try to destroy Al-Islam, but from inside. The enemy within, as they say. The other category, they are part of us. And not in the leadership part. But these people, doubtful. They are not yet certain with their Islam. This is a better category than that category. So when Al-Islam goes to the top and get victorious and run their course of life, they become a very good Muslims. As soon as something happened, we lost a battle here or there, they go on down and they start to talk about Islam. You see what Allah said? يكاد البرق يخطف أبصارهم كلما أضاء لهم مشوا فيه. أضاء means the light becomes strong, clear, and that is Al-Islam. What they do? They walk through it. They go with the Muslims. Their faith raises of doubtful to a poor category. They become Muslims, but in a very, the bottom line of Al-Islam. And some of them, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, will help them to continue going up. As many of al-munafiqeen, even the Prophet time, salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi, they repented and they become good Muslims. And this from this type of people. They couldn't handle the pressure of al-kafirin, so they start to doubt. Seriously, we are on the truth? Seriously, Allah with us or with our enemy? Who's the right one? These questions show that the heart is not settled yet with al-Iman. They are very doubtful people. And these doubtful people, because of their lack of knowledge, their lack of strong spirit, maybe their lack of the community support too. They don't find someone to treat that heart. As Allah said, في قلوبهم مرض. In their heart, there is a sickness. Either their heart is completely sealed, like the first the category of al-kafirin, thus nothing will benefit them. Or their heart still open, the light can go through. But they need a lot of push. You know, in the army, there is so many different category of what they call it? Huh? Rank? No, not ranks. We're talking about the platoons, the battalions. And one of them, their job is to carry the soldier and take them to the battlefield. Soldier carriers. So these, like the soldiers need someone to carry them and take them there to the post of al-Iman. Instead of sitting in the doubtful boost, go up, and push, and push. And some of them, you will succeed saving them from the hell, and some of them, they stay in that until the day come to die as a complete kafir mushrik. Remember, my dear brothers, that La ilaha illallah will not help you if you are not completely believing in it, trusting it, practice it, and have certainty of it. This is why al-kafirin, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described them. If you say la ilaha illallah, you see their heart will become ugly. They don't like to hear that. Like you say something very antist thing to them. Very stupid thing to them. So they, what is this? Please don't talk like that. Why? Because their heart will not welcome la ilaha illallah. See it as a rude statement you are saying in front of them. Why you are talking like that? We are good friends. Your God, my God, and my God is your God, and we all belong to Ibrahim alayhi salam. So what the difference? Moses, Jesus and Muhammad, peace be upon all of them, they are children of Ibrahim. So why do you make a big difference between us? Did you hear that before? We heard it so many times. We say, yes, we believe in Moses and Jesus and Ibrahim and Noah and Lot and every messenger of Allah. And we respect all of them. But our duty is to recognize our message. This is our message sent to us. And what this message is saying to us, we follow it. We believe in it. We accept it in a complete sense. Not 99. Allah will not accept 99 from you. Imagine that. 99 is unacceptable because there is 1% doubt. 1% of unsubmitting. So where this 1% goes? To another God. Either your desire, your material wealth. Didn't the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, تعيس عبد الدرهم, تعيس عبد الدينار, تعيس عبد الخميصة, تعيس وانتكس وإذا شيك فلانتقش. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم saying, curse on the servant of the dollar, the gold, the silver. Dirham is silver and dinar is gold. Even there's people love less than that. They desire much less than silver and gold, but still worshipping them and wanting them. And that part of the sickness of the heart. And al-Iman cannot in any way settle in your heart with anything else. Either your heart have iman or doesn't have iman. There's no in between. Well, 70% believer, 80% believer, 90% believer, we don't have that. We don't accept that at all. If you have any of these, then you have some hypocrisy in your heart. Even if it is very little. And this is why the Prophet ﷺ said about the small hypocrisy, the minor hypocrisy. See, the people, sometimes they don't feel it very well. And sometimes they don't mean it very well. As simple as when you are praying with people around you, you pray in a very good manner, your hands here and tight up and your head down. When you pray alone, you see your hands standing in a lousy way, your hands down, like you are just about to die. That is a sign of hypocrisy. Because Allah is always there, and Allah always seeing you, and Allah is watching you, Allah is hearing you. So what the difference? When you are with the group, you are better than when you are alone. The opposite should be. And this is why the Prophet ﷺ never make his salah very long with the gathering, with the jama'ah. When he prays alone, he used to pray 2, 3, 4, 5 juzu, 5 chapters in Al-Quran in one rak'ah. But he never ever did that with the jama'ah. When he cries when he's alone, or only few people around him. When he submits in his dua and go deep in his dua, always when he's alone. The last 10 days of Ramadan, he even excludes himself from anyone. He doesn't want anyone to come near him. Not as the people make celebrations in the end of Ramadan. Laylatul Qadr to become like an Eid celebration. They stay all the night making quizzes and this and that. The Prophet ﷺ used to stand crying by himself. And when Ramadan, the Sahaba try to hide themselves behind the Prophet ﷺ and pray even behind the curtain. 2, 3, they prayed first night. And the Prophet said, okay, 2, 3, it's not harmful to the people. These 3, second night become 100. And again, the Prophet ﷺ said, it's still a very small number. I may accept myself, I don't know anything about them. The third night, the half of the mosque start to pray behind the Prophet. Imagine that. And the Prophet in one corner, and they are going all, and they are in the street now. And the Prophet said, no, that is too much. I do that because I meant to do that. I don't want to pray jama'ah with you. I'm afraid that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala might make it a compulsory on you. So go and pray by yourselves. If you want to pray groups, pray groups. If you want to pray alone, pray alone. Pray at home, pray at home. Do whatever you want, but don't follow me. And to break that, and he make that command, and he knows someone going to sneak behind that. He stopped the whole thing and he went inside his house. So they can't know what he's doing. But if you are among the people better than you are by yourself, then there's an issue with you. Check, where's that sickness? Either it is a laziness sickness, just because you are lazy, you need support to relish, to have the energy, not because of anything except that. Then try to work in that laziness. And the Prophet ﷺ, one of the things he seek refuge of Allah, to be lazy. Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min al-kasal wal-ajz. Oh Allah, protect me from laziness or disability of not standing before you. And he used to stand, salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi, alone. He even not asking or forcing his wives to come and pray with him. No. Pray alone. And sometimes one of his wives sleeping and he's praying and she's watching him, yani making herself sleepy, and love that scenario to see the Prophet ﷺ standing before her praying and making du'as, and she's listening, and yani like the hair music in her ears. And this is how we know. After his death, she used to talk about him, Hafsa or Aisha or Salama or any of them, radiyallahu anhunna jami'an. So treat that laziness and remind your soul and your heart of the rewards you are getting. Because the soul gets very lazy if they don't remember that reward. What they're going to gain if they stand and do it properly and longer and better. Read in the book of At-Targhib and At-Tarhib about the night prayer, about these great hadith talking about the great reward, the great friendship you are establishing with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that will not happen if you are not standing with Him alone. No one knows about it except him and you. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the major hypocrisy, to wrap up the subject, has two categories. One is a complete sealed heart, complete shirk and kufr. And the other has a doubtful shirk. Doubtful sickness. They might be cured or they stay as they are until they die, and the death will be the death of kafir. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warned them that they will be in the worst place in the hellfire. Worse than any enemy of Islam, bland enemy, clear enemy. And there's hypocrisy by our action. They call it the minor hypocrisy. As the Prophet ﷺ said, one of the categories of that, one of the characters you can tell he has this hypocrisy manners in him or not, if he promise, he break the promises. If he talk, he lies, he never tell the truth. If he being trusted, he will not fulfill his trust. If he has a problem with you or fight you, he will make it a major issue for him. Make a big talk about it like he is the worst enemy of Islam. This one, of course, there is others, and the Quran talk about that. And inshallah, if we reach to Surah Bara'ah, we see how many warning in Surah Bara'ah, chapter 9 and 10 in the Quran, how much of declaring those sicknesses of the hearts. أقول ما تسمعون وأستغفر الله لي ولكم وأسأل الله لي ولكم التوفيق والسداد وجزاكم الله خير الجزاء.